Good evening. We are the Lady and the Gents, and it is truly our pleasure to be with you tonight for the Lucy Craft Laney Museum Virtual Gala. We never take an opportunity to share our gifts and talents with our community for granted, so we want to extend our sincerest gratitude for the opportunity to be before you tonight. And the way we typically introduce ourselves goes a little something like this. My name is T-Y-R-E-O-N. I'm the lady with these gentlemen. T-Y-R-E-O-N. My name is T-Y-R-E-O-N. I'm the lady with these gentlemen. T-Y-R-E-O-N.
By my side. Welcome to the Heritage Gala 30th anniversary celebration for the Lucy Craft Laney Museum Black History. I'm Tyrone Butler, founder and director of the Augusta Mini Theater. Very happy to be here today for this very important occasion. First of all, let me just say thank you to Lady and the Gents. They were terrific. I want to also take this opportunity to recognize some of our sponsors and our donors. The Gala is a signature fundraising event for the museum. It provides an opportunity to celebrate the wealth of Black history we have in the Augusta area. The list of notable African Americans who have called our city home is inspiring. Performers, teachers, activists, doctors, artists, civil servants, and more. This year's fundraiser is dedicated to the repair of the museum's elevator, so that the children with mobility challenges, as well as adults with mobility challenges, will be able to come to the museum and enjoy all that we have here. Please give this worthy cause. Please support this worthy cause. Donating is easy, and you can do it in 2-3 ways. Scan and the QR code on the screen and enter your information. Number two, you can go to georgiagive.org, then type in the search for Lucy Craft Laney Museum. And third, write a check and mail it directly to the museum at the address on the screen. Okay, like I said, I'm happy to be here to share this with you today. And now we're gonna get some inspirational moments. And we're gonna have Ms. Millicent West to come up in just a second.
Greetings, I am Reverend Millicent West, and I am honored to bring the inspiration for tonight's celebration. I call your attention to Philippians chapter 1, verses 3 through 4, where it reads, "I thank my God upon every remembrance of you, always in every prayer of mine for you, all making requests with joy." As we reflect upon this passage of scripture, I think about the Lucy Craft Laney Museum of Black History and all it has stood for and withstood over the last 30 years. It has been surmised that museums provide inspiration through personal connections that are established with those who walk through its doors and in this digital world through their social networks. There is no way you can visit a museum and not be inspired or educated in some way. The personal memories created by our visits to museums such as the Lucy Craft Laney Museum do not expire. They are passed down from generation to generation. So when we think of the audacious work of the great educator whose name the museum proudly bears, or the four women who were instrumental in establishing the framework for the beginnings of the museum, or as visionary executive directors, Teresa White, Christine Miller-Betts, and currently Linda Johnson, who have worked hard and are working hard, not only to bring the vision to reality, but to also keep the museum alive as a testament of the rich African-American history of Augusta and beyond, I can say, as the Apostle Paul said, "I thank my God upon every remembrance of you." But let us not only celebrate tonight, but also remember verse 4, where it states these words, "always in every prayer of mine for you all, making requests with joy." I believe the foundation on which the museum has stood for the past 30 years is prayer. The prayers of those who embraced the vision, the prayers of those who saw what the museum was and what it could become, the prayers of those who understood the value of preserving our cultural, historical, and religious history in this way, not as just a storehouse, but as a testament to the work that God has done. For this is a great and awesome institution, and I hope you will join me and thanking God upon every remembrance of it. Amen. Be blessed. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the 30 years that you have given the Lucy Craft Laney Museum of Black History. We thank you for its partners and supporters, God. We thank you for everyone under the sound of my voice who did not think it robbery to come tonight to celebrate these 30 years. God, we look forward to the future and what you will do. And we give your name praise, glory, and honor in the precious name of Jesus. Amen.
Okay, I want to thank Millicent. You know, great work, wonderful person. So I know you enjoyed that. I know you're inspired now because I am as well. We want to take this opportunity now to introduce our president, our executive director, Ms. Linda Johnson, is going to come up now and give us the reason for the celebration. Ms. Linda Johnson.
Good evening. I'm Linda Johnson, the executive director of the Lucy Craft Laney Museum of Black History and Conference Center. I'm excited to share with you that this year, 2021, is a major milestone for the museum. The museum officially opened its door to the public June 1991. This year, we have a dual celebration. We are celebrating our 15th Heritage Gala and 30 years of preserving the legacy of Miss Laney through art, history, and the preservation of her home. 30 years of providing programs and services that educate and uplift children and adults from Augusta and the surrounding CSRA, throughout Georgia, United States, and visitors from around the world. We have been honored to share and teach others about notable African Americans who call Augusta home and highlight and celebrate the wealth of Black history that we have right here in Augusta. This year, the focus for the 15th Annual Heritage Gala, which is the museum's signature fundraiser, is to raise funds to repair the museum's elevator. Our fundraising goal this year is $100,000. The elevator repair is needed so that children who have physical disabilities can access the Christine Miller Betts Children Academy programs on all levels. Also, so that our patrons who have mobility challenges can access and enjoy the museum exhibits on all floors. As we go forward, we are also celebrating opportunities to continue new and renewed partnerships with various community agencies, other nonprofits, school systems, and foundations that share in our vision of uplifting and providing services to the community through innovative programs, and to also provide creative spaces for artists to showcase their talents as they reach the apex of their profession. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Linda. That was wonderful. We appreciate that information. Now we're going to go just a little bit further with Loretta Jones and this Juanita Bernie. They're going to come up and they're going to give us the history of the Delta House, Inc. and the museum. Loretta Jones will be doing that, and Miss Juanita Bernie will be doing that as well. We're going to talk about the 30-year highlights. So let's welcome those two distinguished young ladies, Loretta Jones and Juanita.
Historical highlights of Delta House Incorporated. On August 29, 1978, Dr. Thelma T. Daley, 16th National President of Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated, officially welcomed Augusta alumni to the Southern region. Offices were installed on October 14, 1978. Sara Geneva Stallings served as the first president for the chapter. 32 SORs were recognized as charter members by their signatures.
Securing a permanent home. As the chapter increased its membership and community outreach, the need for a permanent meeting location became apparent. Sara Juanita Bernie was appointed to chair Property Search Committee. Sara Margaret Jones brought to the attention of the search committee that the home of Miss Lucy Craft Laney might be available. Miss Laney was a distinguished community leader, the founder of Haynes Normal and Industrial Institute, later known as the Lucy Craft Laney High School, and one of the nation's leading educators. At her death, her home was assumed by her niece, Miss Margaret Louise Laney, a member of Delta. Unfortunately, Miss Louise Laney succumbed tragically in a fire that did extensive damage to the Laney home. However, the merits of its bountiful history outweighed the condition of the house. Sarah Viola Evans and Mrs. Josephine Richardson were instrumental in paving the way for Sarah's Margaret Jones and George Lillian Jenkins to speak with Mrs. Thomas Laney. The Laney family gave first option to purchase the house to Augusta Lumney with a request that the legacy of Miss Lucy Craft Laney would be honored and preserved. Several initiatives were developed by the chapter to secure funding. The first being a fundraising project at the Sacred Heart Community Center on November the 4th, 1988. Chapter members provided requested funds. They were Sarah's Justine Washington, Margaret Jones, Louise Rice, Juanita Burney, Leela Stone, Teresa White, and Hertha Blunt. Gwendolyn Roundtree led to incorporate the Delta House, which was established by Augusta alumni. Sarah Viola Evans was appointed to serve as the Laney family representative. As a museum, this building would serve to display data and artifacts on the life of Miss Lucy Craft Laney and other outstanding African Americans, to serve as a venue for community needs, and to expose the talents of gifted artists. House restoration. In 1987, Sarah Teresa White served as the president of the inaugural board of directors. Sarah Ora Griffin served as the project manager for the house restoration. Attorney Carl C. Brown Jr. represented Augusta alumni, and attorney Lansing B. Lee represented the Laney family with the property closing. Representing the chapter were Sarah's Gwendolyn Roundtree, Teresa White, Hertha Blunt, and Juanita Burney. Sarah Viola Evans, accompanied by Miss Josephine Richardson, represented the family. Local legislative leaders assisted in securing other funding from the state of Georgia and the Richmond County Commission.
The Delta House Corporation. The Augusta Alumni Chapter organized Delta House Incorporated as a means of providing funds and promotion of events through the Delta House and the Lucy Craft Laney Museum of Black History. Development of the museum continued under President Executive Director Teresa White until the appointment of Christine Miller Betts. The Lucy Craft Laney Museum of Black History. Keeping the promise to honor the legacy of Miss Lucy Craft Laney, the Laney Museum of Black History became a reality. A nonprofit corporation was formed by members of Augusta Alumni Chapter. Sarah Theresa Rice served as the first executive director of the museum and president of Delta House Incorporated Board of Directors until 1994. A Delta Room within the Lucy Craft Laney Museum was established under Juanita Burney. The permanent exhibit and archives that chronicled the history of Augusta Alumni Chapter of Delta Sigma Theta Incorporated were displayed in a museum by Christine Miller Betts and Loretta Jones. A community-wide dedication in 1991 introduced the importance of the Lucy Craft Laney Museum of Black History and Conference Center to the Central River Savannah River area. Christine Miller Betts became the director of the museum in 1994. Community service programs included a computer center, enrichment program for children, lectures, tours, a senior citizen program, and a youth program under the leadership under the executive director, Christine Miller Betts, and historian Corey Rogers. A bust of Miss Lucy Craft Laney is permanently displayed on the museum ground, secured by a brick fundraising initiative. On June 30th, 2020, after the retirement of Executive Director Christine Miller Betts, Linda Johnson was elected as the Executive Director of Delta House Incorporated and the Lucy Craft Laney Museum of Black History and Conference Center. This has been a historical highlights. The history entirety can be seen on the website.
There'll be no darkness tonight, Lady, our love will shine.
Light in the night.
Just put your trust in my heart and meet me in paradise.
Now is the time,
girl, you're treasure the time I won't steal away. So listen to your heart, lay your body close to mine. Let me fill you with my dreams. I can make you feel alright. And maybe through the years, gonna love you more each day. So I promise you tonight that you will always. Let's make this a night we won't forget. Girl, I need your sweet caress. Reach out to fantasy, two hearts in the beat of ecstasy. Come with me, girl, and I will keep you warm through the shadows of the night. Let me take you with my love. I can make you feel alright. And maybe through the years, even when we're old and gray, I will love you more each day. 'Cause you will always be the lady of my life. Stay with me. There's been trouble at home, 'cause we never talk a lot when we spend time alone, hey. So how I'm supposed to know that something is wrong? Well, we got a way to communicate, it keeps her happy home. And no one does it like me,
babe. Now what we're going to do now, we're going to do something just a little different, okay? We're going to have some testimonials about the museum's success. We're going to have about five speakers going to come up here, and they're going to share some things with you. So,
hello, my name is Representative Henry Wayne Howard, and I'm here at the Laney Museum here, and I'm sitting in my wheelchair in front of an elevator that does not work and has not worked for several years. And we are trying to raise funds for this, to get this elevator to work so that folk like myself can be able to go to each floor of this museum and see all of the exhibits that are here for them to see. So we want to ask you to join in with me and donate to this cause for a worthy cause here at the museum in raising funds to get this elevator back to working. Thank you.
I'm Rita Stubblefield, a member of the board of directors for the museum. Please donate to help repair the elevator so that children can enjoy the academy programs on all three floors. Please donate today. Thank you.
My name is Dr. Lejeune Hickson. The Book of Psalms in the 145th chapter tells us, "Let the generations tell its children of things mighty and great." And this is one of the reasons that the Lucy Craft Laney Museum is here. We should all note that Lucy Craft Laney was first a public school teacher in the Richmond County Public School System. And during that time, white supremacy was on the rise all across the United States. This was in the late 1870s to the early 1880s. Lucy Craft Laney did not like the fact that white supremacists were dictating what should be taught in the public school system. And so she decided that she would build a school of her own where African American children could learn about their heritage without fear. And that school became known as Haynes Normal and Industrial Institute. Our children need to know their history. We need to know our African American history as adults. That's something we don't spend much time on. So let's make a place where our children can come and see what their heritage is and let them enjoy being here. The psalmist, as he said, "Let the generations tell its children of things mighty and great."
I'm Gwen Claiborne. Thank you. I'm so pleased to be invited to give a few words about the museum. And the first thing I wanted to share is how welcome I feel when I come to the museum. Ms. Betts and Corey, they always made us feel so welcome in this beautiful place, museum. Now, I was very pleased when I returned to Augusta after 50 years to learn that this museum was here. And I have friends, an African American lady and an American Indian lady, who told me they had come here for a luncheon. And they said, "You will love going to that museum for a luncheon." And anytime anybody mentions food to me, I get very excited. So I started coming to the museum, and they did not actually underestimate it in any way, because I love the presenters. The luncheon was wonderful, and I just couldn't have been more pleased and impressed with the museum's service to the community at that time.
Hello, I'm Joshua Gale. I used to be a camp advisor here at the Laney Museum during the summer camp that they host. The summer camp was a really great opportunity and experience. I got to work with a lot of amazing people and engage a lot of amazing and outstanding young people over the summer, showing them, you know, about the history of the museum, you know, expanding upon Miss Laney's legacy. Especially being an alumni of Lucy Craft Laney, it was a great opportunity to give back the same way that I got an education here, to give back some of that same education. So that was a great experience for me and something that I greatly enjoyed. And I know they're celebrating their 30th anniversary, so you know, I just wanted to give a few words and give my experience. I currently go to Voorhees College, where I am a senior. I study finance. I am a cadet in the ROTC program.
Hello, my name is Shanita Newton, and I'm a museum supporter. Listen, the museum needs our support. The proceeds from this year's Heritage Gala will go towards the repairing of the museum's elevator, which will allow individuals with mobility issues to enjoy all the floors of the museum. So make your donation. We need your support today. Thanks.
Here we go now. We again thank you all for everything. We're going to have a welcome coming from the city of Augusta, this great city of Augusta. We want to bring on Ms. Francine Scott, Commissioner of Super District 9.
I'm Commissioner Francine Scott, and on behalf of the City of Augusta, I would like to thank you for joining us tonight as we celebrate one of Augusta's premier attractions and key institutions of Black history and preservation in the South. Congratulations to the Lucy Craft Laney Museum of Black History for 30 years of service.
Now we're going to hear from my historian, the museum's historian, Mr. Corey Rogers.
My name is Corey Rogers, the historian at the Lucy Craft Laney Museum of Black History. And in the years I have worked at the Laney Museum, I have come to know the importance of the name Lucy Craft Laney. Ms. Laney's hard work in Augusta would inspire an entire generation of young educators. Ms. Laney's determination and perseverance inspired Mary McLeod Bethune, a young South Carolinian, to go forth and create educational opportunities for Blacks in Florida. Ms. Laney did not approach her life's work unfocused. Ms. Laney was a woman with a plan and a vision. Ms. Laney's vision was to create an environment that allowed for young African-American children to be educated. Her vision was to present the tools necessary that would allow for young African-American children to have choices in life. Our mission at the Laney Museum is to continue to promote the vision of Ms. Laney through art, history, and the preservation of her home at 1116 Phillips Street. It is with this mission in mind that for 30 years we have endeavored to work with various organizations throughout the river region to keep her vision alive. Our summer camps, Black History Bowls, and other activities give the youth of Augusta an opportunity to connect with their cultural roots. For our monthly senior luncheons, we bring in some of the best speakers in the region, from noted cardiologist Dr. Mac Andrew Bowman to pastor of Tabernacle Baptist Church, Reverend Charles Goodman. In 2019, the Laney Museum partnered with Housing and Community Development and the Greater Augusta Arts Council to create 6 new public art installations on Laney Walker Boulevard. We call the Golden Blocks Project. In 2021, we are hopeful to see the installation of phase 2 of the Golden Blocks Project with 4 new murals up in the Laney Walker and Bethlehem communities. There are so many other amazing partnerships and initiatives that the Laney Museum is involved in. With your continued support, we can continue to expand our educational as well as our physical footprint in the river region. By doing this, we honor the vision brought forth by Ms. Laney in 1886. Ms. Laney had very few resources at her disposal, and yet she created the Haynes Institute, the Lamar School of Nursing, and was one of the founders of the Augusta NAACP. Ms. Laney paid it forward to Mary McLeod Bethune, Rosa Tutt, Margaret Louise Laney, Marjorie Carter, and many others. They then, in turn, paid it forward to their protégés. With your continued support, we can ensure that the next generation has the cultural and educational resources, not only just to survive, but to thrive in the 21st century.
All right, we're gonna continue going on with Ms. Jocelyn Vincent. She's a member of the board of directors of the museum here, and she's gonna come up at this time, and she's gonna introduce something very special, and I know you're going to enjoy it.
Good evening. I have the honor of introducing our performer for this evening. You may have seen him on HBO, Showtime, The Tonight Show, or Carnegie Hall. James Stephens III has a wide range of voices. One minute he's Chris Rock and Lil Wayne, and the next moment he's Bill Clinton and Ronald Reagan. The triple threat also plays piano like Duke Ellington, trumpet like Louis Armstrong, and dances like Sammy Davis Jr., and sings like everybody. He's a must-see class act. In the U.S., he has starred on several TV shows and done stand-up comedy appearances on ABC, NBC, CBS, as well as Comedy Central, HBO, Showtime, and MTV. He's worked with Jennifer Aniston, Will Ferrell, Steve Carell, Chris Rock, Garth Brooks, Patti LaBelle, Aretha Franklin, Joe Rogan, George Lopez, Jerry Seinfeld, and others. His quick wit and improv skills make every show different. James's crossover appeal transcends all races, gender, ethnicity, and creed. But what's most important to James is his faith. James is a born-again Christian. He and his wife, Dr. Grace Stevens, own the Asher Theater in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, where they host Las Vegas-style shows. So if you're ever in Myrtle Beach, give yourself a real treat and check out their shows. Now, sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.
Like an old sweet song, baby, I got Georgia on my mind. Hey, what's up? I'm James Stevens III, and I am so elated to be a part of this wonderful charity, and it's awesome, the Lucy Laney Museum, and Miss Lucy was all about education, so that's why I'm here, and we hope that you enjoy my portion of the show. Follow me. Listen, just like Miss Laney, I actually started my foundation to help kids, you know, around the country on say no to drugs. I used to do that. And then I got a chance to perform and travel and work with individuals such as Maya Angelou and Oprah. And that's why I started to do the things that I like to do. So we hope to get you guys really, truly follow us as we take this journey with you tonight. I want to show this is the first African-American owned theater in the history of Myrtle Beach. So I wanted to show that before I go into my performance. And so if you look on the wall, you'll see my artwork. It's Your Mama Joke artwork. And it's the only Your Mama Joke artwork in the world. And it belongs to me. And all the proceeds and sales of any of this artwork goes to kids. So I want you guys to, that's why I thought that we aligned together for what Miss Laney did, because I believe in education. And I went to school at Georgetown, graduated, went to law school at the University of Washington, and I started a foundation for children. So here we are. We've been doing this thing. The people are waiting for us to come and do this thing. So I hope you guys are ready. I hope y'all ready. Come on. I hope you're anticipating. She's excited. Look, she's excited over here. Yeah, so here we go. The Lucy Laney, you know what I'm saying? Army's up. This is going to be good. So here we are. I feel like Eddie Murphy. Come on, let's get this. This is good. Bam. How you guys doing? I'm James Stevens III. You guys are good? So it's this. So the Lucy Laney Museum is in Augusta, Georgia. It's really an awesome museum. Lucy Laney Craft Museum. Lucy Laney was an educator back in the day in Georgia, and she did scholarships and all that stuff for a lot of kids, and she changed the world. She thought that the world should be changed by education, and I agree. I think you guys agree by that. I'll talk about that later, you know what I'm saying? But I'm an impressionist. I am the man of 1,000 voices, and people want to know, how did it start? Well, I was in third grade, and I saw this girl in third grade. I said, I got to get with her. Oh, somebody coughed. They got a half a shot. So I'm in third grade, and I see this girl. So I saw her, and I said, I'm going to get with her. So I did my impression. I was doing my impression of the Cowardly Lion from The Wizard of Oz. Because I know, you know what I'm saying, we used to watch The Wizard of Oz when I was growing up as a kid. So I saw her. So I went up to her and went, open my on the weekend we'll go swimming, I must with all the women. And I really thought I had the girl. I thought I had her, I really did. All of a sudden this little boy jumped in front of me and goes, we represent the lollipop kiss. How do you go to the restroom? Follow the other big road. Because. And that's when I started doing impressions. And I thought I was really good at doing impressions, man. So one of my favorite impressions. I like doing comedians because I work with almost every comedian. And I've been performing in Las Vegas for over 30 years. And when I was in Las Vegas, thank you very much. Thank you.
So in Las Vegas, I got to perform and go see, you know how I got to see? I got to see Red Fox. And you guys saw Sanford and Son. But I saw Red Fox. I would sit in the corner in the dark because he was really dirty. And he would be like, oh, son, he got me a big one. Oh, I sleep with my wedding ring on the wrong finger because I married the wrong damn woman. I love performing with him. It's really cool because I got to meet him, you know, go see him in Vegas. And then I worked in Los Angeles with Eddie Murphy. So you guys know who Eddie Murphy is, right? So Eddie Murphy is so cool because I used to open up for Eddie Murphy every night and at the Comedy Store because he was so good. You know, I come in and I'm doing my thing. Eddie Murphy would come. He make the people, they'd be laughing for like 10 minutes before he'd tell a joke. I mean, he would come, he'd just walk on stage. That's when he was wearing the leather, you know, the leather suits. And he was real young, because I was young too. And you know, he was real young. He'd come out on stage and he'd go, and people laugh for 10 minutes. He'd go, nah, this is good. Look at me. And I used to like, you know what I like? I like when Eddie Murphy and Nick Nolte was in the movie 48 Hours, da-da-da-da-da, and Eddie Murphy come out and go, nah, man, you go, no, you told me I'm gonna get some trim when I got to jail. This is not good. And you remember Nick Nolte go, Jesus Christ, Reggie, what the hell is your problem? I need an applaud for that. You guys not being applauded, but those people down in Georgia, okay, they're killing, they're kicking. So you know what I'm saying? So yeah, and so I started doing and working with comedians and stuff like that. And I do now one of my favorite and one of my best impressions to do is actually Bill Cosby. I know a lot of people don't like Bill Cosby anymore, but what happened? But that doesn't take away from what I do because I'm an impressionist, right? So this is my favorite impression. I like to do Bill Cosby. So check this out. I was sitting in the dentist's chair. Because what happens is when you get old, then your butt turns into glass. That's why you see old people when they sit there, they reach in because they don't want it. And then when you go to the dentist's office, and then the dentist come in and then you put the anesthesia in your mouth. And then obviously when you put the anesthesia in your mouth, then you live to be, And then he wants to talk to you. He says, where are you from? He says, I'm a baby. How long have you been in Myrtle Beach? Mr. Bill Cosby. I love doing the impressions. I love doing impressions. There used to be an older lady named Moms Mabley. Remember back in the day? Moms Mabley, she was like 88 years old, had no teeth in her mouth. She comes out with a purse. And she'd come out and she'd go, how y'all doing? My name is Mom, M-O-M-S, Mom, upside down, W-O-W-S-Y, house, honey. This young man come to me and said, give me your money. He said, I ain't got no money. He said, give me money. He said, I ain't got no money, but you keep doing that, honey. He stuck, pushed it. He said, give me your money. I said, I ain't got no money. He stuck his hand in my bra. He said, give me your money. He said, I ain't got no money, young man, but you keep doing that, I'm gonna write you a check, honey. That was Moms Mabley. Remember Moms Mabley? She was an awesome. You know, so sometimes when I'm performing, so a lot of times there's young people and there's older people. So I always like, what impression do you want to get? So people are like, oh man, can you do, you know, this side of the room right here? Of course, the people in Georgia can't see this side of the room, but these are really, really old people. I mean, like the cast for Cocoon is sitting over here, right here. So I'm going to do the old impressions here and the young people, young impressions on this side. All right, you guys are good? So here we go. So on this side, I'm gonna do Jimmy Stewart. You ready for Jimmy Stewart? That's a long time ago, Jimmy. Harvey is sitting over there. This side of the room, I'm gonna do two of my favorite people. Muhammad Ali and Howard Cosell. Now these are, okay? Even the old people over there know who they are. You know what I'm saying? So here you go. Okay, Howard Cosell, Muhammad Ali. You remember the big fights, and Howard Cosell would always be jabbing Muhammad Ali, right? He goes, good evening, sports fans. This is Howard Cosell. Muhammad Ali, you're old and you're slow. You don't have the stamina or the agility as the Cassius Clay from yesteryear. And Muhammad always grabbed the mic and goes, give me that microphone, Howard Cosell, because I'm the greatest of all time. I'm the greatest. I'm the greatest. Joe Frazier, Joe Frazier, Joe Frazier. And so I love doing impressions. I'm going to tell you. And so listen, and I'll tell you who so I like to do. I performed for 3 different presidents in my life, okay? Yes. Thank you very much. I performed for President Ronald Reagan. I performed for President Clinton. And I performed for President Barack Obama. Okay, so now the way I got to perform for President Ronald Reagan is I was on the Say No to Drugs program with Nancy Reagan. So I traveled all over the country with the kids, right? So I would be at the kids. And one day we were at a high school and this barricade of all like these black limousines came up. And all of a sudden I saw this tall historic figure come out like Ronald Reagan got out and was like. And I'm telling you, when he got out of the car, the wind was blowing and not a strand of his hair was moving. You understand what I'm saying? But if you look at the skin on the side of his neck, and so we were talking to the kids in the classroom. He come in the classroom, and he's taller than me, right? So he looks down at me because, you know, he figured, you know what I'm saying? He feel like I was, because I was like an African-American, I was like a rapper or something. So he went, no, seriously. So he looked at me, he went, Well, I can't rap and I can't sing. You know, drugs is not my thing. I mean, I love President Reagan. I think that President Reagan was the greatest president ever. Really, seriously? Really, seriously. And then I got to perform for Barack Obama. And so when I got to perform for Barack Obama, all my white liberal friends in Los Angeles would go, oh my God, aren't you so proud to have been performing for the first African-American president? I said, no, he's half black and he's half white. So take responsibility for your half, okay? I mean, seriously, I'm gonna be honest with you. I don't think that Obama was the first black president. You know why? Because, you know why? He was in office for what, 8 years? 8 years, a black man in the White House and the police was never called. That is no, you know what I'm saying? That's not the black president. If he was gonna be the first black president, you know that didn't get busted a couple times, got Jamaicans on the White House lawn. So you know, he wasn't the first black president, but I bet you know who was the first black president. Who was the first black president? Bill Clinton, we know that, that's right. You see, and we know that Bill Clinton was the first, because Bill Clinton was in office for 8 years as well. In 8 years, the police was called 47 times. And Bill Clinton, he's the type of guy, he just go out and talk to police, he didn't care. He goes, well, you know what, we're just having a good time in here, I'll tell you, we're just smoking, but we're not in hell. And I tell you, you can't arrest me, I'm the president, damn it, I'm the president. Oh my God. So that was cool. That was really cool. So you guys good? You having a good time? And I hope, give it up for me. I'm looking. So I know the people in Georgia hearing you guys applaud. And I want the people in Georgia, listen, I want to make sure. Now, did everybody hear? Because listen, you guys are saying, I'm in my theater, yes. And because, I mean, raise your hands, you got your shots. Everybody got your shots? Oh my God, almost everybody got the shot. What shot did you get? What shot did you get, sir? Which one?
Pfizer.
You got the Pfizer? Okay. See the Pfizer? What you got? Pfizer, who got the Moderna? Anybody got Moderna? Okay, cool. See, the Pfizer was, it's like a California thing. It's like a California shot. All my friends go, oh my God, I got the Pfizer. You know what I'm saying? You're like, did it hurt? No, it didn't hurt. It was so good. It was nice. I was good. You know what I'm saying? And people got, because I got the Pfizer, I'm telling you. The Pfizer, because it's a West Coast shot. And then the East Coast shot is a Moderna, right? Like the Moderna? Guys, like an Italian shot. You know, yeah, I got the Moderna. How you doing? I got the Moderna. What you get? Hey, I got a Moderna. Did it hurt? No, a little stiff. That's all, a little stiff, but I'm good. You know what I'm saying? And you know, the problem with this whole pandemic thing was the black folk thought that the white people tried to kill them with this whole vaccine stuff, so they didn't want to take it. No. So they said, I'm not going to take it until they come out with a black shot. So then they came out with the Johnson. So the black people go, man, you going to get it? No, I'm waiting for the Johnson. I'm not going to take it until the Johnson come out. I'm going to get the Johnson. And then all of a sudden, my cousin got the shot, right? He got the shot. He goes, man, don't take the Johnson. Man, I paralyzed. Man, I was paralyzed. For 3 days, I was paralyzed. So now they don't want to take the Johnson. I want to take the Johnson. And then they sent the Johnson down to Mexico. The Mexicans got pissed. Go, come on, no Johnson. No Johnson. No Sin Johnson. Now, I want to tell you seriously, because this whole pandemic thing was sort of scary. Wasn't it scary? In the beginning, you didn't know what it was, and people tell you something, you're like, what? I don't feel nothing. You know what I'm saying? They're like, there's something going on out there. I don't feel nothing. You know what I'm saying? You're walking, you don't look, and all of a sudden you see, like all of a sudden you go, oh, my nose is running. Is it COVID? Everything was COVID, right? You're so scared. You know, your wife sneezed, your wife be laying in your arm, she sneezed, you go, hey. You don't even say bless you, you go, hey. And I'm gonna be honest with you, I went to jail one time during COVID. And it wasn't that I did anything, I sneezed in my grandmama's face. And she's like, she called the police talking about I tried to kill her for the COVID. So I had to go to jail. So I was just in jail for a couple hours, and they put me in front of the judge. The judge said, what you do? I said, I sneezed. I just sneezed. He goes, you know, it's COVID and all this stuff, so I'm going to order you to get tested for COVID. So I had to get tested for COVID. Then she goes, well, you're going to have to stay quarantined for 14 days. I said, well, I'm staying with her. So I had to stay with my grandmother, right? So about 4 or 5 days in, so I get a letter in the mail. I'm thinking it's from the courts, right? I looked on the letter for COVID-19. I looked, and it says, I saw positive. I just dropped the letter. I dropped the letter. And then I looked at my grandmother. She was, because you know, she's one of those busy grandmamas. So I grabbed the letter, and I dropped the letter, and I said, I'm sorry, Grandma. And so she came over to the kitchen table. She grabbed it. She goes, I don't know why you're so sorry. This says that you were tested positive for cocaine on the 19th. So that's what I'm trying to say. Oh, we got the kids in here. Got some younger kids in here. They're cool. They came in. They have some young kids in the back. They're younger. When I say kids, they're like 18, 19. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Again, they don't know nothing. You know what I'm saying? They have no idea. All they do is smoke pot all day long. That's the society we live in right now. If kids, I'm telling you, you can't even be in the club if you ain't smoking pot. You know what I'm saying? But you know why? Because we got 330 million people, and the government wants 300 million of them to just be sitting around like this. When I grew up, I didn't really know what pot was. I mean, I watched people. I was always observing them. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, who want to smoke pot? You ever see people that smoke pot? You know what I mean? Because they do like this. I was with these guys one time, and they went, and then they go, and then they look at me, and they go, oh, this is good. This. Why you want to smoke that? Oh, my God. And then cocaine, when I went through college and stuff like that, I was hanging out with a lot of white kids with a lot of money. That was their drug of choice, cocaine. You don't want to drink cocaine. I mean, drink cocaine. That'll tell you how stupid I am right now, right? These people would take cocaine, and you'd be out, your friends out, they take cocaine, they're like, oh, I got to do it. I got to do it. I'm like, oh, my God. Why you want to do this? That's why I became a say no to drugs thing. Because I'm like, whoa, somebody got to stop these people. You know what I'm saying? Cocaine to make you so paranoid. I had a friend, he would come, he'd be peeking out the door. There's somebody out there. There's somebody out there. Yeah, it's just your face. It's you. You are looking in the mirror. I remember when I was growing up, my mom used to come to my room and say, I will slap the black off of you. I used to look at the other kids in our family, see when I've ever done this before. I mean, there's no way my mom could slap the black off anyone. She would have everyone in the neighborhood going, slap me, I'm going on a job interview. One guy was so black, she had to hit him 5 times. He said, slap me again, they think I was Puerto Rican. Are you guys with me on this so I can start over, you know what I'm saying? Are we having fun so far? I'm just enjoying doing this. I'm enjoying this because of the fact that, you know, the people from Augusta, you know, I performed for them before. Now, and what I'm going to do is, even though they've seen me do this right here, I'm also going to let you guys see what I do as far as the Motown show. And the Motown show, I'm going to cut and let you guys see. Do you guys watch the Motown show? It was awesome, huh? So I'm going to cut right now. I'm going to let you see, since we're in the middle of the show, you guys can come back to me if you want, but I'm going to cut to me doing Lionel Richie.
Hello, somebody. Come on. I'm loving you all the way from Birmingham, Alabama. Tuskegee, are you in the house? Here we go. Woo! Oh, yeah. We love you. Hello, I'm Lionel Richie. How are you? Woo! Do you enjoy the show so far? I'm Lionel Richie. I was enjoying myself. I want people to hear this all the way in Tuskegee. Number one hits, and everyone loved my love songs. Can you hear me? But one of the most beautiful songs I ever written was with a beautiful young lady from Detroit. Her name was Donna Ross.
Oh, you.
remember that song? So let's hear you say the bumps with me.
There's another guy from New Jersey. Anybody from New Jersey here? Remember Bruce Springsteen? Yeah, Bruce Springsteen. Oh my God, Bruce Springsteen was a white guy, can sing really well, really good looking, really cute, but you couldn't understand nothing he said. You couldn't understand nothing he says. Okay, here we go. All right, here we go. Bruce Springsteen, here we go. This is where you guys can go. We're going to cut to, even though they still watching me right now, we're going to cut to me doing Stevie Wonder. Ha ha. Give it up.
1972.
Now this is where I do my favorite performer. You can turn that a little bit down right here, a little bit. My favorite performer here, I want to do first, well, actually my favorite black performer all time, Elvis Presley. You laughing, but you understand, come on. In the 60s, there's no way a white boy could move like that and dance like that in the 60s. Unless the government did some engineering, you know what I'm saying? And they used to do that back in the 50s, right? I'm thinking he was a little bit of Pat Boone and a lot of Jack Wilson. What do you think? So, ladies and gentlemen, you like the big Elvis or the little Elvis, baby?
Love Elvis.
You love Elvis? You like the little one or the big one? Yeah, you don't matter. Yeah, you look like I'll take anyone I can get, you know what I'm saying? Here you go.
She likes the big Elvis.
The big Elvis was...
I'll be a teddy bear. I put a chain around my neck. Leave me everywhere. Oh, let me be.
Oh, let me be
a teddy bear. I don't wanna be a tiger. A tiger play a tiger. I don't wanna be a lion. I don't wanna be your teddy bear. Well, I put a chain around my neck. Lead me everywhere. Oh, let me be.
Oh, let me be
a teddy bear.
And I love Elvis Presley. I love Elvis Presley. But my favorite was the Man in Black.
Johnny Cash.
I had some young girls in here last night, and I said, I'm getting ready to do the Man in Black. They said, oh my God, Will Smith. And they looking at me now. Look at me. Look at my lips. This is really, I am really doing Johnny Cash. Here we go.
Well, my daddy left home when I was 3, then he must put my mom on me. But this old guitar and the empty bottle boo. Well, I can't blame him, cause he went and hid in the meanest thing that he ever did. For his elf, he went and named me Sue. Well, he must have thought it was quite a joke. Seems I have to live my whole life through. Some guy will giggle and I get red. Another guy laugh and I bust his head. I'll tell you, life ain't easy for a boy named Sue. So Augusta, Georgia, if you ever have a son, call him Caitlyn Jenner, anything except Sue.
So now for all the people in Augusta, I'm gonna cut to the end of the show, and I'm gonna be doing Four Tops, Temptations. You're gonna love that. If you saw me do Temptations, I am Levi Stubbs and I am the Four Tops. Cut.
I've never met a girl who makes me feel the way that you do.
You're all right.
Whenever I'm asked who makes my dream real, I say that you do.
Get out of sight.
I'll always be a four top.
One, two, three, four, five. You can't count?
I can
Temptations.
Count. You know, I'm gonna tell them a story. Did you sit here, young man? I'm gonna tell you a story about a small town where the Temptations lived. And up on the hill was where the four tops lived. We always looked down on our little brothers. Let me take you there. You remember this, guys?
Ain't no woman like the one I got.
Don't come better.
To make love, we have to take a lot.
She don't ask
love.
Black pages to a list.
Ain't no woman like the one I love.
How you wanna sing it? You still need my help.
Okay, okay, cool. I'll take my place for just this song. Look, we are the four tops.
Let me teach you how to sing.
Each day through my window, I watch her as she passes by. I say to myself, you're such a lucky guy. To have a girl like her is truly a dream come true. Out of all the fellas in the world, she belongs to me. But it was just my imagination. Once again,
won't you learn how to clap?
her pretty face got the best of me. Suddenly, you came into my life and gave it meaning and pure delight. Now the looks I've learned to do with them, cause now I know it's love that really counts. Cause I know it's
only skin deep. Yeah, yeah,
yeah. Yes, it is. It lets me know that your love is real. A pretty face you may not possess, but what I like about you is your tenderness. A pretty face, maybe some guy's face, but I'll take a loving in his place. Cause I know
it's only skin deep. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's
only skin deep.
Yes, it is.
Like you. I'm gonna show you something. Four Tops, 1985. Yeah. You were a young man, you weren't even born yet. I'm gonna show you how we used to do it. I'm gonna show you how your mama did it. Oh!
My girl,
yeah.
When
how it used to be. She was my girl. I'm 4 times for life. She's my girl. Let me show you something. Show this. Watch this. Check this out. Check this out, boy. Look at this.
Sound like you can keep a woman.
I got sunshine, ooh, on a cloudy day.
So how about we do one together?
All right, well, let's play one. Well, hold on.
You can't beat
me. How many people think you did it 4 times?
You can't
good?
Beat me.
How many people like the Temptations? Okay, look, I'll tell you what. You put your jacket on, I'll do a song with you.
You can't beat me. If you can't beat them, join them. Come on.
I'll be friendly on this one. Put your jacket on. You better, you ready?
Take that off. Nobody wants to see your body.
Are you ready? You ready, little boy?
Keep up.
I'ma keep up.
Can turn a gray sky blue.
Make it rain if I want it to.
Oh, I can build a castle from a single grain of sand.
I can make a ship sail on dry land.
But my life is incomplete and I'm so cold.
Rehearse it. I love you when nobody else.
Come on, y'all. We out of here. We've been the Temptations. So I gotta go. So in my act, I talk about black people, white people, stick people, Asian people, even Michael Jackson. I do this deliberately because God created all diverse races, put us on this planet, hopefully we get along. Unfortunately, it doesn't happen like he planned. But I feel if we can come together as a small group and have the fun we had this evening, we should be able to come together as a race and combat the things such as homeless, racism, AIDS, drug addiction, and all the other things affecting this planet. It's up to the people to make it happen because the government's not doing its job. So when I'm traveling around the country, even around the world, I try to educate children because only through education we can overcome ignorance. Because the blood that those boys have shed in Afghanistan, Iraq, is black, white, Asian, Jewish, Italian. It's about the people, but more importantly, it's about our children. See, it's really hard to change the mind of an adult, but it's easy to mold the mind of a child. So I thank God for my parents who saw no color and made me the man I am today. I'm going to close my show doing Ray Charles singing America the Beautiful.
Oh, beautiful, for space the sky, for amber waves.
Oh, you know the show is going to be good if I do.
Hey, oh, gray, hey, I do that in the show. For purple mountain and those, those majesty. Above the fruited.
Love doing what I do, baby.
I said, America. Oh, America, I love this land, baby. God shed his grace. Oh, Lord, oh, on thee and the rashes and the roaches. And I can't buy no gas at the gas pump here. And crown that good, baby. With that brotherhood, I just talk, that's all I do. From sea to shining sea.
Thank you so much. God bless you.
Now we're going to call up. Thank you. Let me just first say thank you, Brother Stevens. Great job. Loved it. Okay, now let's move on. We're going to get Miss Kathy Johnson is going to come up at this time, and she's going to do the presentation of the Heritage Award. And then we're going to have the presentation of the Christine Miller Best Legacy Award by Ms. Rosa Clemon, President of the Executive Board, Ms. Rosa Clemon.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am Kathy Johnson, Lucy Craft Laney Museum of Black History Board Member. At this time, it gives me immense pleasure to present the 2021 Heritage Award. The recipient of this award has demonstrated outstanding service to the arts through philanthropy and engagement, and has, as a result, made a significant impact on the cultural fabric of the CSRA and beyond. Please join me in recognizing the 2021 Heritage Award recipient, Mr. James.
Please join me in recognizing the 2021 Heritage Award recipient, Mr. James Vinson.
First, I want to say, I'm truly honored to be recognized for the Heritage Award. Without question, God has graced my life with opportunities that I know are not of my hand, nor any other human's hands. Secondly, for the majority of my adult life, I've had a supportive partner by my side who enhanced my strengths and mitigated my weaknesses, was instrumental in raising two successful sons of which we are extremely proud of. Who could ask for more than that? Again, thank you for this recognition, and may God continue to bless you and keep you safe from harm.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Rosa Clemons, President of the Board of Directors at the Lucy Craft Laney Museum. At this time, it gives me great pleasure to present the 2021 Chris Miller Betts Legacy Award. The recipient of this award has demonstrated exemplary philanthropy and engagement, which has significantly impacted the health and viability of the museum. Please join me in recognizing this year's Chris Miller Betts Legacy Award, Dr. Mac Bowman.
Thank you so much for this tremendous honor. Thank the members of the board and all who are associated with this wonderful institution for our community. For me, it's special in so many ways. When I think about Ms. Laney and not only what she was as a stalwart, as a fulcrum in this community for the day-to-day citizens, but in expanding educational opportunities in this community, and what a lot of people don't realize, what she did to expand the healthcare opportunities in this community with the founding of the Lamar School of Nursing, which ultimately morphed with the Barrett School of Nursing to become the University Hospital School of Nursing, one of the first integrated schools of nursing in the southeastern United States. She was a warrior. She was a champion, not just for those who had, those who were educated or who won the up and up, but for the average citizens and the what some would class as the less than average citizens in this community. Her effort, her every energy output was to uplift each and everyone that she could, every time that she could, everywhere that she could. Her legacy here continues to work through the members of the board and the folks involved with the museum, because that's what they try to do. They embellish those things from our past, but they also emphasize those things in our present as they prepare to move us positively into our future. That's an immense responsibility, it's an immense effort, and it's one that they embrace, that you embrace. You don't shy from it. And that's what God expects. What he has given to us are things that are there not just for us, but they are about enhancing us and what we have to mold it, to craft it, to grow it into something bigger and better, not for what it does for us, but for what it does for others. I take that very personally. I thank God for the challenges in my life that have brought me to where I am. But I know each and every day that it's truly not about me. It is about that service that he expects me to render from him to me to others. And as I say often and always, to God be the glory for the things that he has done and for all that he has, he expects and that he has prepared us to do in service to him and in service to others. Thank you so much for this. I'll treasure it always. Thank you.
Thank you. I want to acknowledge a couple of people. Again, I'm Tyrone Butler. I'm glad to have been here to do this for you. We want to say very special thank you to ladies and the gents band. Yeah, let's give them a hand. Wonderful job. We're going to go by Brother Stevens again, James Stevens III. He did a fantastic job as well. One special thank you to our sponsors and our donors, our guests, Corporation of the Delta House Incorporated, of course, the Gala 30th Anniversary Planning Committee. You gotta have a planning committee, so great, great job. And now, this guy that's coming up next, I guess he's a good guy, but I'm gonna let you decide. Mr. Leon Maven's gonna come up here, and he's the vice president of the executive board. You know, that means that I can run for president of the United States. Okay, let's bring on Leon.
Good evening, I'm Leon Maven, vice president of the Lucy Craft Lane Museum of Black Histories, board of directors. I hope you enjoyed this evening's 15th annual gala. First, I would like to thank Tyrone Butler, founder and executive director of our own Augusta Mini Theater, for doing such an awesome job serving as master of ceremony for this year's Heritage Gala. Second, I would also like to thank one of Augusta's premier bands, the Lady and the Gents, for providing the music entertainment throughout the gala. A big thank you to our featured artist and entertainer, James Stephen III, for a stellar performance this evening. He was so nice, we had to do him twice. He performed last year, we had to bring him back again this year. Thank you again, James Stephen III. I would also like to thank the golfers and sponsors of this year's Laney Museum Golf Tournament for your support. Funds from the golf tournament will also go toward the repairing of the elevator. To raise additional funds for the elevator project, we sold tickets for our Heritage Gala raffle. I am pleased to announce that we have three winners. The first place winner will receive $500. Second place winner will receive $250. And the third place winner will receive nothing. No, I'm playing. Will receive $100. Our winners are, drum roll please. I would also like to thank all of our sponsors and donors for your continuous support of the Lucycraft Laney Museum of Black History. The Heritage Gala is successful largely due to the sponsorships and donations we receive from corporations, businesses, organizations, churches, and of course, our dedicated friends. Your support helped to preserve the legacy of nationally prominent educator and social reformer, Ms. Lucycraft Laney. If you have not made a donation, it's not too late. There is still time to give. The three ways to donate are listed on the screen. And they are, number one, scan the QR code. Or number two, type the Georgia Gives link directly into your internet browser or access this link from the museum's website under the donate tab. And number three, you can just pull out your checkbooks and write a big check and send it directly to the museum at 1116 Phillips Street, Augusta, Georgia, 30901. You can now get your dance on in the comfort of your own home or where you are watching the gala by listening to the smooth sounds of the Lady and the Gents. Enjoy the rest of your evening. Thank you again for your support of the Lucycraft Laney Museum Heritage Gala.
me. You said I'm so crazy.
So crazy, baby.
Coming home intoxicated. I said I just wanna love you.
I just wanna love you.
I guess that's why I'm so elated.
Thank you again for coming out. We really enjoyed this evening. Didn't we have a wonderful time? I mean, it was just terrific, really. And I really enjoyed it. And I'm glad the two organizations are coming together and working together like we are, the Augusta Minute Theater and this wonderful museum. Don't forget now, on October 8, 1975, the Minute Theater was founded, and we celebrate 46 years this year of the work of the Augusta Minute Theater. Thank you for having me here, and let's support this museum. Seriously, let's support. this night.